is, then we'll deal with it. Okay? Because trust me, we'll just deal with it. I have no desire to ruin your reputation or anything. We'll deal with it. I'll give you an opportunity to get it together. But at this point, I got Mr. Giacchinis, who is facing a life sentence.
Your Honor, okay? I'm not aware of that.
So if you came to court intoxicated, you have a problem. Do you understand me?
Your Honor, I can represent as an officer of the court. I am not intoxicated.
Okay. You can't even represent to me anything so far. So
I apologize about the misrepresentation about the other
woman. Josephine's name was Christine. She was your ex-girlfriend. Turns out you only knew her for 20 minutes. You said you were rear-ended. Your car has absolutely no rear-end damage. Has substantial front-end damage. It's not even registered to you. It's registered to a person who's incarcerated in the Nevada Department of Corrections. I'm not quite sure it can get much worse. So just go ahead and blow. Let's get it over with. But let me tell you, my desire will not be to hurt you. It will be to help you. Okay? My only desire will be to help you and to make sure that this gentleman who's sitting at this table, he's facing a life sentence. Okay?
Your Honor,
he is facing a life sentence.
Your Honor, I've been an attorney for 16 years. I've had 67 jury trials. I would in no way jeopardize my client's future by not being
then
at
just
my
blow.
Best.
So I can be,
Your Honor,
then just blow so I can be confident.
I don't see the probable cause for me to blow.
I stated it repeatedly, so go ahead and blow.
Okay. Go ahead and have a seat, sir. Go ahead and have a seat.
Is your Honor ordering me to blow?
I absolutely am ordering you. And there's a complete record, so if you're not happy with what I've asked you to do, then you have a remedy. You can take me to the Supreme Court.
Judge, I have nothing but respect and honor for Your Honor.
And
Your Honor's treated me fairly since the inception of this case. You've given me a fair trial this far.
Well, it's not you I'm worried about. It's Mr. Giacchinis.
Your Honor, my concerns are for my client as well.
And you know what? If I were you, my only interest would be in clearing my name. So clear your name.
I see, sir.
Judge, I'm presumed innocent. Why should I have to clear my name? Am I charged with a crime?
Absolutely not. I have no desire to charge you with a crime. I hope you understand this. My only desire will be to help you. If there's a problem, my only desire will be to help you and to protect. The only person I care about is you and Mr. Giacchinis right now. That's all I care about.
I respect that, Your Honor.
Okay.
And I'm willing to go forward.
You can then blow.
Have a seat. Judge, this is an intoxicometer.
It's a PBT. I used it routinely in Muni Court. I know exactly what. In fact, this is my old marshal.
I respect this gentleman.
Okay? He used to do it for me all the time.
Just take a deep breath. Just blow on it.
Did you get a good enough blow? Okay. You know you got to blow good.
I know you have to blow good. I've never been in before, Judge.
I know, but you've probably represented people that have been arrested for DUI. And you got to blow good. I'm confident you know that.
We don't have to do it again.
We don't? You want to show me? You got a good enough read? Okay.
4052, Your Honor. It's residual from last night. I am stone sober.
Mr. Caramangle, if I was you, I would just be quiet at this point.
I'm sorry, Your Honor.
Okay. No, is it done?
No. Still climbing.
Okay.
There it is.
Okay. Okay, for the record, your blood alcohol is a .075. And, Raul, will you state your name for the record?
Raul.
And you were ordered to come up here by myself, is that correct?
That's correct.
And you used to do these tests for me routinely in MuniCourt?
Yes.
And this is the same machine that we used to use in MuniCourt?
It is the same unit we use.
And will you state for the record the machine that you used?
It is a PBT Alco Sensor 3, intoxometer.
And you've been properly trained in how to perform that test?
Yes.
Okay, and you properly followed all the procedures like you've been trained to do, is that correct?
That's correct.
Okay. Thank you very much for coming up here at my request. Okay. If the record was, and you, do you want to see it, Mr. Caramingo?
Well, Your Honor.
Do you want to, did you clear it?
No, Your Honor, I know this gentleman, and he's a okay. And I believe what he says. And Judge, again?
See, that's not so brave, the judge.
Well, that may have been an overstatement, Your Honor. I admit that I did have drinks last night, and I lost my grandmother about 2 weeks ago. And I've been under a lot of pressure. I wanted the best for my client, and it was a mistake to drink last night. And I apologize, Your Honor, and I don't know what else to say. I just know that I can try this case.
You were here at 11:15 a.m., is that correct? Can you say for the record when he appeared? Because we didn't finish with our criminal calendar until about 11.
Yeah, it was approximately 11:15, 11:20 this morning.
Okay, so 11:15, 11:20, Mr. Caramingo appeared. It is now, by the court's clock, 1:46 p.m., almost 1.5 hours later, and you're a .075.
According to the intoxicant, Your Honor.
Right. I think that you probably had more to drink than you were. I mean, I was hoping it was going to say zero. So at this point,
I was going to say 0.01. And I apologize. No disrespect to the court. And I just apologize, Your Honor.
I hope you weren't involved.
I was honest with Your Honor, and I said that I did the shots of tequila last night, Your Honor. I was in my office till 4 in the morning last night, and I did drink when I got home. I was stressed. I lost my grandmother a month ago. I lost my brother in 99.
You said 2 weeks ago, now you said a month, okay?
June 2nd was when my grandmother died.
I think you should stop, because it just keeps getting worse.
I apologize.
So, I mean, I cannot let an attorney proceed under these types of conditions. I don't think you have a concussion. And I sure hope there's no reports of hit and run. I hope you weren't involved in a hit and run.
I was not, Your Honor.
I hope not.
I did speak with the gentleman who hit me, and he took off. He was a Mexican gentleman in pickup. And I did not exchange information with him because he was satisfied to leave. His damage was minimal.
The guy that you hit was satisfied to leave.
Now
know why you didn't call 911.
Your Honor, philosophically, I've never called 911 in my life.
Because you were intoxicated, and you were worried about being arrested.
Your Honor, I was not intoxicated.
So, and again, my only desire at this point is to protect. I don't know, I've never had an attorney. Maybe the state can enlighten me. My only desire at this point is to protect Mr. Jacachunas. I cannot absolutely allow an attorney to proceed. I don't think you have a concussion. I don't think you hit your head. I don't think you have a concussion. I think you're dazed and confused and can't tell a straight story because you're too intoxicated. And that's okay. You know what?
I respectfully disagree.
And I don't know you that well, and maybe you have a problem, and so my only desire is to see that maybe you can get some help.
I appreciate that, Your Honor, but I can represent to the court that I do not have a problem. I've been under a lot of stress.
Okay.
It was my mistake to drink last night, and I regret it. And I can represent to the court that I was not intoxicated at any point in time, legally.
Ooh, unless you drank sometime while you were here in the courthouse. I know you didn't, because you were pretty much either in my sight or my bailiff's.